I knew the girls were missing the day before. And I can tell you, I at least, and I think most people thought, oh, well, you know, they're hanging out with friends. They've had a fight with mom. No such thing happened. Don't misunderstand me. But we didn't think much about it. And when the next day, when their bodies were found, it was shocking to everybody. It was certainly shocking to me because in Carroll County, such a crime was unprecedented. You know, people kill each other sometimes, but generally it's a crime of passion. It's about boyfriends, girlfriends, husband, wives, or some emotional dispute. We've never had, in my time, I was first prosecutor in 1987, we never had a murder in a robbery or a random murder. You know, we had drunk driving deaths, we had murders of husbands and wives, but nothing like this. And so it was tremendously shocking. And the outpouring of law enforcement support was incredible then, because not only did the FBI come in extreme numbers, but the law enforcement, the police departments of the surrounding counties, the sheriff's departments, the city police departments, they all sent detectives. And in those early days, there were plenty of leads, you know, but there was no great lead. You know, people have asked me sometimes, was there a point where y'all knew who did it, but you couldn't prove it? No. When I was involved, that point was never reached. There was never a time where we thought, this is the person, we just don't have enough to charge. But there was so much physical evidence at the crime, and the crime had been found so immediately after it had been committed, that it's the sort of thing that experienced law enforcement officers, experienced investigators, all believe, well, this is going to be solved really quickly. And normally it would be. It's shocking to me that it hasn't been solved today. In today's world, we have cell phone evidence and we have DNA evidence. But if you had been a police officer in 1960 and you had arrived at this crime scene with the traditional physical evidence that was there, and then not to mention the fact, of course, we had video and audio of the person I think certainly killed the girls, you would be certain you were going to catch them within 48 hours. So when you add in the fact that we have evidence today, or we have investigatory methods that we didn't have in the 60s, all police officers, I believe anybody who was involved, I doubt anybody in that first 24 hours had any doubt it was going to be solved within 2-3 days. And
just from the evidence at the scene?
Yes, yes. The circumstances of the crime, yes. Mm-hmm. And, you know, then after that, what happened was they developed a system where when there were tips or there were hints or there were reason to believe somebody was in the neighborhood, they would assign, we had so many officers working on it, that the guys would, they give them sheets, in effect, go find these people and interview them about where they were that day and so on. And so there was this unbelievable manpower, totally unprecedented in my experience, working on this and enthusiastically and passionately. And I would have been certain. If you had asked me at the time, I said, oh, next couple of days, they're going to find a suspect and action's going to be taken. Not because I had any particular feeling about a particular thing. It's just because of the circumstances of the crime.
At the scene.
Yes. I've told people before, there were times in those early days, it'd be late at night, and guys wouldn't go home because they thought, no, we're going to go out and do this, and then we're going to solve this, because that's the perception everybody had. Not because we had necessarily a really good lead, just because it just seemed like, well, of course this is going to be solved. The location is such a, it's not a tourist attraction or anything. You know, if you weren't from around here, you'd have no reason to even know such a place existed. You know, the trail actually terminates at the bridge. The girls had gone out because it was a beautiful day, mm-hmm. 52 degrees, as I recall, in February. They just decided we're going to go out for a walk. And I remember at the time I would see on the internet or nationally people saying, I can't believe those girls were out there, as it was the wilderness. You could walk from my office downtown out to where they were in 20 minutes, maybe half an hour tops. And you could drive there in 2 minutes, 3 minutes. And so it was just on the edge of town. In fact, there were houses. In fact, where the crime scene is, there's a house up on a hill that can actually look down. The backyard can look down and see that house, or that the crime scene, I should say. And so the idea that they were someplace dangerous. I wouldn't have hesitated to have my child at that age to be walking out there. Mm-hmm. That's another thing that's shocking about the whole thing. Well, I guess I fear at this point that the most likely thing is, and this is a terrible thing to hope for, is that some other crime would be solved and the person, as has sometimes happened in the past, the person would say, oh, I committed this crime in Delphi also. I started to say, on the one hand, because it's not a very famous kind of place, I always tend to think it was a local person. But the fact that it's not been solved, and the fact there doesn't appear to be any motivation for it, it appears to be a serial killer type of thing. I'm not saying it is, I don't know, but makes me wonder if it wasn't a random act by somebody who isn't around here all the time. But I don't know. I mean, I'd like to tell you I have a strong feeling about that, but I don't. Early on, I would have said, well, it's surely somebody local, because who would know to be out there? Why would you be out there? Why would you even expect to find any other human beings out there in February?
Mm-hmm.
It's broad daylight. This is something that needs to be emphasized. This is not like these girls were in a back alley in the middle of the night. Mm-hmm. They're in broad daylight in Carroll County, Indiana.